Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Secret of Mana. Last episode we saved Gnome and he agreed to join us, lend us his magic powers, and we found our way down here in the Pandora Ruins. And between videos, I gained a couple of levels, well maybe one or two, and I also got Undine and Gnome for the sprite up to level 2, and I got Undine up to level 2 for the girl as well, and I just didn't bother leveling up Gnome for her, because the spells aren't really that useful. Anyways, we have these new enemies here, the elemental sort. Not sure if that's what they're called, but sometimes, I'm not sure if it's these ones, but it might be the later ones that cast sabers on themselves. So they will have an elemental affinity. But I don't think our characters are weak to any elements or anything like that, so I don't know really what it does. And here's just an empty room with some swords and a tomato man, so oh yeah, they cast Moon Saber, I guess. I forget what Moon Saber does. Second and sets of 3, Moon Saber drained HP from your enemies and gave it to you when you attack them. Maybe that's what it does in this game too, I forget. Well, I'll find out when I get Luna. Moon magic. Oh yeah, like that's a surprise. We're gonna get Moon magic later. We're going to be able to use pretty much any spell that enemies are able to use too, so it's pretty nice. And let's just leave those tomato man. I don't feel like charging up my weapon and okay, yeah, let's heal up a bit. I don't feel like charging on my weapon or using a spell against the tomato man to get rid of them. It takes too long. Just live and let live. Alright, so let's get around here and up these stairs. Wow, this room's pretty mazy. Seems like they could have built that room a little bit more efficiently. And this is the last room, so that was a pretty short dungeon. Only like 3 minutes. And here is Thanatos, the evilest of the evil. Yeah, give us back Fan and Dilek, you evil fairy. He's not too scared with pink hair. So he's reviving the Mana Fortress to bring the people of the world together. Does that mean he's just bringing them together in death or something? I don't know. Seems like kind of a crazy plan. But of course all the villains in these Squaresoft games are crazy. Oh, trapdoor! No! Here's boss time. And this is Wall Face. Sort of like in Final Fantasy IV, the Doom Wall. Except this guy doesn't charge anything. Yet, at least. So this guy has 3 main eyes. Or 3 parts, I guess. The 2 eyes there and 1 eye in the middle. And it's basically speed down on my main character there. Makes it so you walk around as if you're charging your weapon really slowly. But anyway, yeah, he has 3 eyes there. The 2 eyes on left and the right there. I think the left one casts curative magic and the right one think the right one will revive the others if they die. And they also cast other spells. Like freeze. But, if you want to kill this guy quickly, just unload a bunch of gem missiles and earth slides right on the center right there. And I'm just showing you what happens when you get rid of the left and the right eyes without taking care of the middle eye. Let's just heal up now. I think the right eye is almost dead. There we go. Looks like, what can we do now? Walk around. Not gonna take any damage. Oh, crap. I don't think we're killing it fast enough. In trouble. Closing on all spikes. We're gonna die. You know what? It's the end of the world, and I feel fine. Let's see what happens when the wall crushes us. Come on, Mr. Wall, speed it up. And we're dead. But, yeah, let's not do that, and just, let's kill him. See? Gem missiles. Or Earth Slide, whatever you want. Just take care of him real quickly. Also, freezes him while he's getting attacked. There we go. So if you want to avoid the wall coming towards you, just, you know, douse them with gem missiles or earth slides right away, and don't worry about the left or the right eye. So once the middle eye dies, the whole thing dies. Ready go! And we get the Bow's Orb. Great, a weapon I never use. Yeah, game's over, Thanatos. Or not. Dada fada no! Hi lady, what's your excuse? Darn, I was washing the dishes. And here's Gemma, he was spaced out, I guess. I guess we're gonna have to investigate Thanatos' major plan here. Let's get out of here. Let's go see Luca now. Now we have Happy Music at Pandora. Yay! And also, since we rescued all the people, we can get a few things now. We can go to the shop on the east side of town. No, not that house. Let's go see what's in this house anyway. Why not? Yay, people are back to normal. We saved the day. Again. Nobody wants war. Stupid lady. Well, you sure did a good job while you were spacing out down at the ruins there. Well, I assume I've been in that house before. And here's the other armor shop. It's just a little minor upgrade. It's the Cobra bracelets here. And everything else we have. So let's just get three of these Cobra bracelets. Cobra bracelets. Hard to say there. Nope. And I will eventually have to sell all my excess equipment sooner or later. Getting a little crowded there. And everybody's defense goes up by 2 or so. There we go, that's better. So now let's head up to the castle. See what she has to say. I wanna talk to you! Too bad, I'm gonna talk to you. Gee, sorry. Didn't realize you were Queen of friggin' England. Guys, say anything else? What about you, green hair guy? Nope. Looks like they don't really care that their castle is saved. They're still hung up on the war 15 years ago. Damn, Empire. Alright, so let's go to the king's room here. Oh yeah, more people who don't believe that we're heroes. You need to get rid of that pink bandana. I think it's turning off people. I guess we are sort of a little ragtag group, you know? The sprite there, and the girl, who's like a rich priss from Pandora, I guess. But she did have martial arts moves, I guess, having those brass knuckles. So, now we get the treasures from Pandora. 50 GP. 50 GP. Is this gonna be 50 GP? Nope, we get a spear orb. Nice. And we get the sword orb. And, let me guess, 50 GP. And another 50 GP. I could have just put one chest with 200 GP. I mean, it's 50 GP so much it can only fit in one chest. I don't know. But anyway, make sure you get that sword and spears orb. Usually when I play this, sometimes when I play this game, I completely forget about them, so for a lot of the time, I'm behind in my sword and spear levels. But I think if you miss some of the treasures with the orbs in them, that you'll be able to compensate that by getting several orbs from chests later on. Like if you miss a whip's orb and find a chest much later on with a whip's orb in it, it might have two. But we have to do like Gemma said now and go back to the Water Palace. Too bad there's no cannon travel guy. Actually, let's use that yellow thing right there. Flips us to the next level there. Saves us about 10 seconds, I guess. Oh, it's really not that long of a walk from Pandora to the Water Palace. Alright, level up. Nice. I first met Dialect Bear, standing there with those four soldiers. So handsome. Boy, I wish he didn't go off and fight that witch. Anyway, let's unlock the Water Palace again. Maybe that's to keep Luca from the outside world. She must be some sort of monster or something. I don't know. She's 200, maybe she has some evil magic powers. If she gets outside. And maybe she's like a vampire or something. She goes outside, the sun will eat her skin.